Hola, my name is María Korol. I'm a visual artist. I make drawings and I like to explore other materials like clay and animation according to each project. I was born in Buenos Aires, Argentina in 1980 in the middle of a brutal dictatorship. It was a dictatorship that took the lives of 30,000 people. The government, through the police and the military, were kidnapping and torturing and disappearing people. My parents were very young, they were 18 at the time, and my aunt was almost disappeared, she was taken by the police. My grandfather was able to rescue her, and my parents were so frightened with that situation that they went into exile to Brazil, where I grew up until I was 5 years old. And we went back to Buenos Aires, and I started school, and they split, and I started going between the two of them. The historical forces and the family drama really marked me. In my artwork, I am interested in bringing together these historical forces and the relationships between people, and to figure out that spot where an individual can stand, become an active observer, and gain agency through comprehension, analysis, and a recreation of the world around her. I am also interested in memory, in the way that memory informs and transforms imagination and the other way around. In 2019, I started working on Nightwork, and I started to become more and more interested in the lives of women from small Eastern European towns who left to go to Buenos Aires, the big city, looking for opportunity. Buenos Aires and Argentina at the time was one of the top 10 richest countries in the world. Argentina, unlike the United States, had opened its doors, its gates to immigrants from Europe. So there wasn't a quota the way that the United States applied to immigrants from Italy or from Ireland. It was completely open and it was just flooded with immigrants from Europe. The Swimigdal was a Jewish mafia that was active at that time, and they were trafficking women from Eastern European towns and forcing them into sex labor. I learned that some of the women, however, were already in that line of work or chose to go into it because they preferred to do this instead of staying in these tiny towns that were very impoverished, and also the pogroms were happening. I think it's really important to observe how the bodies relate to one another inside of the composition. There is communication that is happening through those bodies, through that body language, and through those facial expressions inside of the composition and with the viewer as well. I learned that during this time, the late 19th century, early 20th century, Argentina had its gates open to all these immigrants from all over Europe. So you see that represented in these bottles, where you have British last names and Italian last names and Spanish and French. So these were people that were coming to Argentina and starting wineries and starting businesses at the same time that the Swimigdal was trafficking women into the country. How do we think about people in daunting circumstances? How do we relate to their stories? Do we pity them? Do we sentimentalize or idealize the lives that they had? And I was really trying to fight against those approaches and to just give them sort of like a full existence. You know, they are people, they are in a certain circumstance, and inside of those circumstances, they're able to find their own agency. They're able to recreate what's around them to a certain degree. Again, even if it is that they can laugh, that they can stand against, or that they can make fun of those in power, that's good, you know, it's something. I can make the analogy that the ink drawings are my brain thinking in Spanish, and the abstract drawings are my brain thinking in English with a Spanish under structure. There's a story in both of them. They might seem like two separate things, but they're one. The stories that I tell in both artworks are the same. The stories have to do with women. They have to do with people that are often unheard, people that are not celebrated. A big influence in my work is literature. One of the writers that I like the best is Roberto Bolaño. He was a Chilean writer, And like me, he went into exile because of the dictatorship in Chile. He lived in Mexico and then he ended up in Spain. The emotional charge of that book and the stories were really seeping into my drawings, so much so that I even named one of my small abstracts, like one of the characters in that book, Piel Divina. I also was really drawn to an Argentine painter. Her name is Marcia Schwartz, and I was very young when I saw a portrait that she did of Batato Barea. Batato Barea was a trans performance artist from Buenos Aires, and Marcia Schwartz painted this amazing portrait of her where she's wearing a gown, like a wedding veil, and it's really funny. You know that it's Batato, but she also looks, you know, like very distorted and hilarious. And I saw that when I was maybe 11 years old, and I was like, oh wow, art is good. I feel like my training in dance, even though I decided to change to a new creative endeavor with visual arts, still really rings with me in the way that I am able to enter the physicality of my characters in my drawings, how I sometimes even mimic like a certain attitude in my studio, and I kind of try it on my body, even if it's a villainous or like a, something that I don't want to become, but for a second just inhabiting that attitude and then drawing it from imagination is something that I think comes from a lot of that training of, you know, using your body to express feelings and emotions and ideas. I feel like humor is a tool that I had to develop and nourish to survive. I really find it important to have a sense of humor about the broken bridge between people's intentions and actions, and about our vulnerabilities, about the absurdity of life. I have a lot of friends in Chile, a lot of friends in Colombia, in Mexico, I travel. The sense of humor that people have, like the darkest humor, people think that the British have dark humor, they have not been to Colombia. and I love that about it. I think that's like a life force that pushes you forward. With these ones, it's almost like a stage in between the abstract and the figurative. They started as ink on panel, and then I started to go into my abstraction mode, and then I kind of stopped myself because I wanted the figures to stay. And oftentimes when I use color, for some reason I just like go into a more abstract, more formal kind of language. And in these ones I just pulled back for a second and allowed the figures to exist so I could have like more specific bits of narrative happen in color. Anyway, I was imagining sort of this swirling energy of history, how the past comes into the present, and how a lot of things that you think we have survived and that they're not with us anymore, then boom, they happen again. Historical moments just have a way of regurgitating themselves, of transforming and becoming a new way of oppression, and it's very repetitive and cyclical. Hopefully each time we react to it differently and learn how to stop it. Yeah, I think sometimes people are surprised, especially when I am working fully abstract and I start telling the stories that got me going with the work. It's harder maybe for people to understand because the narrative and the figures have become embedded and completely buried under the formal language. I do feel that the story is vibrating under there, like the intention and the essence of the story remains. But it is a little bit harder to see it at first sight. And that's why the two modes of work go side by side, and they are the same stories, just told a bit differently.